Brought to you by Cobras TV and Pulos Poultry. My name is Theo, this is our first episode, so I'd like to welcome the Cobras TV team. To my right, we have Yanni Iosifidis.
Good afternoon,
and I could be here.
Good on you, Yanni. To his right, we've got the recently retired 300-game superstar from the actual Cobras, whose career was cut down in his prime due to a crippling knee injury. We've got Vela.
True. But in fact, before you come to me, I think for our viewers, can we cut down a gym doing the knee? Or is it too early? Oh, we'll come back to it.
Champagne comedy from Tommy.
But the best thing is that instead of retiring gracefully, he's becoming extremely bitter, a bitter former player. And the good news is that we've called Vela Venom, which we'll cross to later on. So we're looking forward to that.
Stay tuned.
And to the right, already introduced himself, is the former... former 10-time Victorian Junior Snowboarding Champion, commencing in 1972, we have Tommy Gunn at the end.
Oh, thanks, Mark. It's, you've been very generous. It's actually 1977, but thank you.
It's also Theo.
Oh.
Okay, cool. Thank you. All right, just a quick rundown of what we're going to run through today. Obviously, you can tell that there's going to be plenty of comedy. Not by us, but by people that will be generally associated with the show. We're going to highlight, got a few clips from the Cobras TV launch party, which happened just before Christmas, and there's a couple of key interviews with some key stakeholders from the Cobras and some very hardcore supporters. From that, then we'll cross to Yanni, who will look at the 2012 season in review, and then following that, we'll cross forward to the 2013 season and the key issues and the main issues that are coming from that so far. Then we'll...
The season hasn't started yet.
No, it hasn't. It's pre-season.
Pre-season.
Yeah.
Big issues pre-season. Lack of numbers, commitment, the squad struggling early on.
The constant contract wrangling, I guess you could say, from Iosifidis.
Mercenary.
Correct.
Well,
a great man. Let's point that out. A great man.
I think that's what we can discuss straight away. Daniel, what did you think about the controversy with Steve and the re-signing as the coach?
Look, at the end of the day, the Cobras got the man they wanted. Did they pay too much? Possibly.
Did they really get the man they wanted?
Well,
I heard
the man they could afford. Yeah. They may have wanted someone more qualified. He's got one season under his belt. It was a successful season, however... there were other options out there. So whether they got the man they wanted, that's up for debate.
Will there be a succession plan as it was with Buckley and Malthouse with Belkos and Yossa?
Well, currently Johnny T's been appointed the reserve coach. So
is that breaking news?
Yeah, well, it is. It's a Cobras exclusive here.
Make sure to put the exclusive watermark on.
Yes, that's right. I can formally announce that Johnny T has been announced as the reserve coach.
Excellent.
Johnny. Just watch out. Yossa, you're back. Knives have been sharpened. So it's a musket, Ange Postecoglou type of situation happening there at the Cobras, but it is an exclusive.
Well, I think it worked out well for Jim Gilton and Mehmet Drakovic.
That's right. They could get Francis.
He
got the boot.
Yes. Good for anyway, so moving on to the Cobras 2012 launch party, which is going to cross to a short clip. Yeah, sorry, a few clips.
A bit of audio. Clips.
So we'll be back to discuss this in greater depth.
Welcome back to Cobras TV, I'm Yanni Iosifidis, and now we're going to talk about the 2012 season and the success of that season. Vela,
yes.
Your thoughts on the season?
Obviously, a great season, being promoted, a number of hard games, well played, well coached, a very good team structure that Steve implemented. First time as a coach as well, you really couldn't ask, I guess, much more than
you
what.
Could've.
Well, listen, you probably could by around 13. Promotion would have been so, it could have been so, but obviously it went down to the last couple of games.
The season was a success, but the end of the season, could that be a sign of things to come for this year? Because they did drop off, you know, they really had to win it at the end. It wasn't theirs.
Very true. True, Yanni. I guess we were struck down by a number of injuries, especially one significant one, I might add.
Not to keep players, though. Listen,
obviously great season. We did very well. We scored more than what we conceded, which is the name of the game. We held out.
Soccer.
Yes, listen. We did well, obviously being promoted.
Jim, was the successful season, though, overshadowed by some controversy and off the pitch?
Well, listen, there were a few little issues which we needed to go to. It ended up going to the Supreme Court.
Listen,
there was an issue with spitting.
Special mention to our friends out at Keysborough too.
Yes, I'll be polite to you.
And yes, you will be seeing us next year. It just won't be in Proggy too.
True. Exactly, we stay full, that's right.
Tell us about Spittergate, because it was a controversial part of the year, and it did involve yourself.
That's right, it did. I've got the clearance from my solicitor, so I can go ahead and disclose all the... I did spit on that bloke. Listen, I was confused. I was heavily knocked. He went for me. He went for the man. He didn't go for the ball. Witnesses have come forward and did provide evidence. There wasn't any evidence, though. No video footage. But he went for the man. He didn't go for the ball. I accidentally spat on the ground. The players, the referee thought otherwise, but listen, a great decision. Did serve 1 week, but a great decision, which kept, you know, made us a stronger.
Did it mar your final year?
Listen,
truly,
we were promoted. We were promoted, Tommy. So the end result was us having a successful season.
I accidentally told an umpire to get fucked once.
Yes.
Okay, so listen, I've just sat here and listened to you guys, you know, prattle along and stuff like that, talking about a successful season and everything, but ultimately, aren't the Cobras still in the same division that they started last year in?
In one word, yes.
Thank you.
Was it a success? Hey. The FFE changed the structure, as we all know, and I guess it's a positive for some, it's a negative for others. We won, you can't take that away from us. So, we'll take it, unfortunately.
Hi to our friends at the FFE as well.
Hi.
Not being privy to the Steve Iosifidis contract negotiations, given that they are still in the same division, call it whatever you like, do you think he deserves more money?
Listen, I've spoken to his manager, Bernie Bandage, the same manager that handled the Harry Kill saga, and we'll get to that later on. Listen, I'm not too sure. Should he be receiving a bonus? Same division.
Well,
I don't know. I'm putting it out there.
It's not
panel yet. Members, I don't know.
Isn't the bonus coaching a great club like the Caulfield Cobras? Isn't that the bonus?
You think so. Look, for a normal, I guess, sports person or someone like that would be, but when you're a mercenary chasing any last dollar you can get, then, hey, it all comes down to the bottom line.
There have been rumours that he did team up with old mate Dainty.
Dainty, what division was it in? Division 6
North
or 7?
Division North somewhere in England. There was a little bit of chatter that he may have headed over to the club that Dainty formerly represented, but it did not come to fruition, so Cobras have got him.
Well, we haven't got any footage of this, but Steve was sent at Tullamarine Airport, a return ticket to England, so who knows? He may be seeking some sort of international player. Who knows?
Nothing is surprising.
Having now moved on to 2013 and training now commence, how do you see, is there a premiership hangover?
Not going by current numbers. I believe last week's training session had 9 people. Of those 9, 7 were spuds. So the players that need to be there are not on the track yet. Boys, you need to get down there, because if the Cobras are going to be successful in 2013, the best players do need to be on the pitch. And you can't be your best player in April. You've got to prepare yourself from now until the start of the season. And when the season commences, bang, you're ready to go.
Daniel, do we actually have some footage?
Or Yanni?
We don't have any footage yet, but we're working on it.
Actually, I think we do have some footage.
Do we?
Yeah, we do have footage, I think, Yanni.
We do. We've got some, I wouldn't say exclusive, but we do have some some several minutes worth of some sort of training footage.
Balls out? No,
we don't have balls out at this stage. It's very early, so we're doing a lot of running. But as Yanni said, we want numbers down. We need players to come and support the Cobras.
Let's go to the footage.
Top five, we don't know. Mm, mm. You know, what's going to depend on
just wait just to see the pre-season, what deals can be done, and hopefully we can revisit this topic again.
Thanks very much for sitting on the fence there, Jim. If it's any consolation, Theo's take will be that they'll be mid-table. If they can get a run together, maybe sneak a couple of wins early on, then possibly top four, top five. But unfortunately, I don't think we won't be seeing the excitement and drama that happened down at Snakehead last year with the promotion that the Cobras obtained last year. Right, moving on. It's a segment that we're going to be looking at throughout the whole year. Hopefully it'll only take a couple of weeks, but the idea is for Tommy Gunn down on the end there to contact a certain high profile soccer coach. I'll pass to him to fill you in a little bit more.
Thanks, Theo. I think to get some credibility here at Cobras TV, we have to bring the big names to the show. And what bigger name in world football at the moment, or perhaps in the last decade or millennium, has there been than Terry Venables? And
all the way he likes to be called is
Altel.
That's right, Altel.
Now Altel, one of the biggest names in football history, up there with Pele. I'll suspect even bigger. We're going to try and contact Venables for the TV show. Starting this week, we'll be contacting his management. We'll contact them 10 times a day if we have to via email until we get a response. I think we will get Venables on the line. I think he's got a lot to answer for in regards to the Iran issue. Mm-hmm. And it'd be good to speak to him. And also, he's currently recording records, I think. I've done a bit of a Google search. He's got a few records out at the moment. So it's good to talk about his music career as well. And you know, there's rumours that he may come back and coach Liverpool.
Well, his name
seems to be floated around. Every time there's a coaching position, it's Venables or Keegan.
If there's anyone that has got any contacts internationally, listen, email us at cobrastv1hd@gmail.com. Anything that can support us in our search, Tommy is working through this 24/7.
And Terry, if you're watching, email us.
Terry,
we'd love to have you on.
Us. Do something to
try. Get on the show. You can be our first guest. After we get you, we think the celebrities will roll in. We'll have Keegan lined up, Harry Redknapp.
Yep. Tommy,
Warren Erickson.
Johnny Warren.
Johnny. Well, we need a psychic for that, don't we?
Listen, we're going to post things on our Facebook account. It's Cobras TV 1HD as well. So, listen, if you know of anyone, you know, join us in our search.
A search for Terry. And can we get this? Do we have like an intro here? Can we run the intro?
Yeah, I think we can.
There we go. There's the intro coming up.
Thank you very much for that, Tommy. Looking forward to the weekly updates on that. We move on to the lookalikes. Just because it's our first show, the idea is it's going to be interactive. So if there's any lookalikes out there, of anybody you may know, please feel free to send them in to the... Right, yeah, so that's the lookalikes. Like I said, get them in, email or Facebook, that'll be good. Now, here comes a time for what could be potentially become the most volatile or volcanic segment on the show going forward. It's a time when Vela actually takes his takes all the bitterness deep down and spits it out and really gives someone a real bake. So here we are for the first time, is Vela's Venom.
Thanks. What I'm going to say, there's only one club here in Australia. They keep on saying the Victory are the biggest club in Australia. Well, I disagree. It's the Cobras Football Club that is the biggest. Why I tell you that? They think Victory, they are the biggest club. Well, let's start with one thing I want to mention. The Kuehl experiment. Back in August of 2011, Melbourne Victory officially confirmed the signing of a 33-year-old Harry Kuehl on a three-year contract. Was he going to play for money? Was he going to play for the love of the game? Well, we know that's all crap. Let's look at some stats that I just found. Harry Kuehl said the terms of his conditions in regards to his salary was he would play for a base salary, something sort of what Steve Iosifidis is going to do, but anyway, plus a big cut of any revenue he brought to the club in terms of memberships, jersey sales, and sponsorships. A baseline would be agreed using previous year's figures. On top of that, fuel would be 80% of the rest. The cheapest Victory membership costs $190. Cobras costs around about what? $90?
$1.90.
That's
right. Yeah, God.
Now, 10,000 extra memberships sold off the back of Kill's decision. That would net him a cool $1.5 million. So was it worth it of getting Harry Kill to the club for one season? Don't forget, he left after one season. The results were what we learned from the experiment. Harry Kill's wife had a brief appearance on Neighbours. He bailed on the club. He loved CQ Bar in the city. He couldn't score in a massage parlour. And now he's prostituting himself to any club that will even entertain training. Now, the club finished 8th place and missed the finals campaign. And Victory finished 8th on the table. Now, you tell me who the biggest club is as of the last couple of years. The Cobras finishing first, signing a former NSL player to finish top, or Melbourne Victory. That's Vela's Venom. Email us at cobrastv1hd@gmail.com and let us know of your thoughts. Panel members, what do you think?
I think the biggest club has to be the Victory. How many people did the Cobras get? Cobras got 20 people to agree with, 20. On a good day.
Listen, is that officially or unofficially? Gate takings haven't been brought in at the moment, but yeah.
Well, you're right about
what's
the number.
In your bank? You look at the Cobras bank balance and the Victory bank balance. Mm-hmm. I think the Cobras are the biggest club. Mm-hmm.
Well, it's the
point.
They're $7 a stubby. They should be. Well, I was blown away by that, Venom, to be honest. After your fence sitting antics before, and your known lack of confrontation skills, what you just delivered then is absolutely outstanding.
We need Steve Irwin in to wrestle the Venom.
I'm looking forward to Vela's Venom next week, I tell you that for free. From my point of view, Melbourne Victory shits all over Cobras. Just a bit of professionalism. And the fact that we've got four dickheads trying to do a YouTube show based on...
Hey, you know what? They probably actually do.
Yeah. Well, hang on. Has Melbourne Victory got a actual segments or any type of footage of, like, within the inner circles?
They actually do, yes.
They do? Okay. I'll take that back.
Hey, well, to get more insights into Melbourne Victory, maybe I would get an employee of them down here who... That may be an upcoming thing.
Well, maybe, Theo, you could provide us a little bit of insight into your ongoing campaign to sack Ange, give Ange the keys to the city. That's a thing.
What do you think of Ange, Theo?
Well, look, I'm sure he's a nice guy and probably donates his time to charity and everything like that. But look, I was brought up in an era where it was a cutthroat business. Not just soccer we're talking about here, we're talking about anything. You know, but I mean, I'm not sure about you guys, but